us. Guru, you know, is Sanskrit word. And in Sanskrit, the beauty is that most of these words, there is a root word. And once you understand the root word, the meaning of the word itself becomes very, very clear, very, very, very transparent. So the word Guru, one of the root words which could be taken for creating the word Guru is Gri. Now the word Gri has the meaning which means to sing, to praise, to speak up. So of course, this is very clear that Guru is a person who knows so much about so many things, and of course he is the right person who would be speaking, who would be singing, who would be praising the God and the knowledge and the wisdom and so on. Because all the gurus here would know that when they initiate a disciple, then the process of initiation of a disciple is organized in a manner when the disciple is held in the lap of the guru, and then a sacred thread is sometimes given, which is also in Sanskrit called upnayan, which means to take him closer to something. And taking closer to what? Taking closer to the knowledge. And in this process, when this initiation process is complete, then the person is called Dvija, which means he is born again. So in this, the ritual is something like a mother. And here again the word is Guru Mata. Guru is like a mother who keep the disciple in his womb of knowledge and consciousness, and then delivers him to the life of his spirit. There is also another third Gri root word, which means to sprinkle, to wet something. And again, this word goes again Girati. This of course is very, very clear. Guru is the person who can eliminate the dryness, who can sprinkle the love, who can sprinkle the grace upon the disciples. Also another word for Guru, which starts with the root word Gur, and this means to lift, to raise. And this Gur word is of course to raise the disciples to a higher level of knowledge, higher level of consciousness, higher level of wisdom. So these are four root words, and once you see these four root words, I'm sure when you look at the Gurus again, you can look at them again, all these four meanings. And if I have to combine all these four words together and just say, summarize them once again, so let me again quote for those who, I see some Indian faces here, so they will of course understand. For others, I will try to explain it again. This is again a Sanskrit shloka from Advaita Tarak Upanishad, and it is the 16th verse of that, where it says, Gu Shabdas Andhavar. So the word Guru, the first word, the Gu, is actually denotes darkness. Syat Guru Shabdas Dinodhika. And the Ru word is the second word, which means to nirodha, to stop it. And therefore, andhakara nirodhatvata, the person who takes you from the andhakara to stop it, is Guru Vitta Vidhyate. So that person is known as the Guru. So this was the one meaning, I think, about the Guru, and I probably now I think it would be easier for many of you to see the context of the Guru.